There they go again, Mr. President. There they go again. Call it a one-year anniversary reenactment. Senate Democrats reopening the sad and embarrassing chapter they wrote last September. We all remember this pattern from last time around. Shoot first, correct the facts later.
And welcome back. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell there last week slamming Democrats for using a poorly sourced and thinly reported New York Times story to renew their calls for impeachment against Supreme Court Justice Brett Kavanaugh. The article, which appeared to drop a bombshell sexual misconduct accusation, stemmed from an excerpt from a book penned by Times reporters Robin Pogrebin and Kate Kelly. It's called The Education of Brett Kavanaugh. The Times later corrected their story to reflect the fact that the alleged victim refused to be interviewed for the book, and friends say she has no memory of the incident in question. The book, which was released last Tuesday, provides a deeper look into Kavanaugh's yesteryears at Yale University, but at some point, critics point out it fails to provide answers to the accusations against him. Still with us, Chris Wilson, Jesse Jane Duff, and Dr. Lauren Wright. All right, guys, also in a recent op-ed for the Wall Street Journal, Peggy Noonan makes the case that the left's continuing assault on Brett Kavanaugh will never stop. She lays out a handful of reasons, one being that the steady drum of allegations diminishes not only Kavanaugh's stature, but that of the court itself, which currently holds a conservative majority. In an opinion piece for the National Review, Kyle Smith says the campaign against Brett Kavanaugh can be summed up in a few words. He is or was a bro. Smith points out a passage in which the new book says, while Gorsuch was largely uncontroversial, Kavanaugh was known as a bro, a highly social animal whose proximity to powerful men raised uncomfortable questions. So is it okay to be a bro anymore, Chris Wilson?
You know, I really don't think it has anything to do with him being a bro. I think this has, actually, I don't think the attacks against him have much to do with him being Brett Kavanaugh or with it being Brett Kavanaugh. I think anybody Trump nominated would have gone through the same sort of attacks. They would have found some sort of charges to make. And as preposterous as these charges apparently have been against Brett Kavanaugh, they would have had found equally preposterous charges. I mean, no Trump nominee would have been satisfactory to the left. So the goal of the left is to do nothing more than to destroy Kavanaugh. And by destroying Kavanaugh, as you said, they will diminish, or as Peggy Noonan points out, they will diminish his rulings, they'll diminish the court, and also somehow in their mind lends credence to these various court packing schemes that they're coming up with. Let's expand the court. Let's do term limits for the court. I'm old enough to remember whenever they thought it was that you actually should have less members on the court. So the whole aspect behind this, I believe, really has very little to do with Brett Kavanaugh. So he is an unfortunate byproduct and collateral damage for the left and attempt to try and destroy the Trump appointment, regardless of who it would have been.
I have to disagree with that, John. I mean, that's so unfair to every Republican Supreme Court nominee that's gotten through without these kind of allegations. I mean, are we just saying it's a matter of luck? I mean, are we all just walking around, but we're so lucky we haven't been accused?
I think the other thing, too, we can't forget is that Democrats always see that seat as Merrick Garland's seat, the one that Barack Obama did not get to nominate, or nominated but didn't get confirmed because of Mitch McConnell standing in the way of that. And that's, you know, they'll always attack. The other thing too, last word to Jesse, 30 seconds here, but this is also meant to send a chilling effect to potential future nominees for the Supreme Court, right, Jesse?
I think it's unfair to suggest that just because this Republican had these accusations must mean that there's something there. I think that's very unfair because the fact of the matter is we know that this is turning into this is a conservative court, and they know that this is up about Roe v. Wade. We know this is about Roe v. Wade. So whoever was going to get nominated by this president was going to get attacked because he will become, like Peggy Noonan says, a footnote as to the one that was viably accused of sexual assault if they should reverse Roe v. Wade.
All right, Jesse, and unfortunately,
that's what it boils down to.
We'll have to wrap it up there. Great conversation, guys. We'll look forward to having you all back in real soon. That's going to do it for this Monday edition of Newsmax Now. Thanks for watching. Good.